Hello everyone. So I'm Camille Melien, the CTO and co-founder of Yellow and OpenWare. We have in our team Alexis, the executive chairman, which is the creator of one of the co-founder of GSR, the biggest market maker in crypto industry. On the financial side, we have Bakhtiar, who has a lot of experience. Actually, he worked 18 years in PwC, so he has a lot of experience in traditional finance. Myself as a CTO and Luis as a CTO, we have been working together for 15 years together. We build a startup in big data, in finance and in blockchain. And finally, we have Sergey, our CEO, COO, which has been the head of R&D of Bitfury. So Bitfury, it's a big Bitcoin miner creator company. And we are working with an amazing team of 100 people all around the world, mainly in Ukraine and in Thailand, in Chiang Mai. So let's talk about the problem. So we have seen the rise of cryptocurrency and blockchain technologies. In the last few years, we have witnessed the explosion of DeFi and thousands of applications deployed on Ethereum and other blockchains. So it was really an exciting time, really big innovation and so on. And do you recognize this one, CryptoKitties? It's like the first application who almost killed Ethereum network. So one application with just a bit of hype just completely crashed the network. We discovered what is the network congestion, what is a crazy high gas fees. And that's something we, I think everyone in the room knows now. Like how painful it can be to make a transaction on Ethereum, how expensive it is. So blockchain doesn't scale, and that's a big problem. And because of this problem, there were a lot of innovation recently, a lot of blockchain release with new technologies. Name a few, like Solana, they introduce the proof of history. Polygon, they released in production the sharding, which is still not yet in production on Ethereum. So it has been extremely, because of this problem, the industry created a lot of innovation, and users actually followed. So you can see, in about 1 year, Ethereum market shares dropped from 96% to almost 50%. And still Ethereum had some growth. So it means the size of the market exploded. And yet we didn't really solve the problem of scalability. So now we have two problems. So blockchain is still not scalable. We made some progress, but I don't think we will solve really the problem anytime soon. And now we have a lot of users with a lot of liquidity spread around a lot of blockchain with a really bad interconnection. So we have a problem of scaling and a problem of blockchain very badly interconnected. So who are we again? So we are two big players of the crypto industry. So Yellow has been doing market making and startup incubation, while OpenWare is the editor of OpenDAX, which is a software to make crypto trading exchange. And about 1 year ago, we both companies merged into one to build the Yellow Network. So, what is the Yellow Network? It's a peer-to-peer financial layer, blockchain agnostic, trustworthy and high performance. So with this network, basically two exchanges can connect together and peer liquidity, like fetch the order book of the other network and provide its own. It's blockchain agnostic because each broker can connect, each exchange can connect to different exchange and push the liquidity into the network. And it's trust. Finally, it's trustworthy and high performance using the state channel technology. And so what is the state channel? So it's a very interesting technology. It's not a blockchain. We are not doing yet another blockchain. It's a technology that was introduced in Bitcoin Lightning Network and deployed in production in 2017. So it's a very, very well-known technology, battle-tested. And the state channel is the generalization of this technology. So we can basically use this technology for many use cases, from gaming to finance. So basically it allows to make off-chain transaction, so very, very high performance and still have the security, a very good level of security using cryptography algorithm. So let's take a few examples to our use case, how it works. So let's say two brokers, two exchange wants to open a state channel together. First, they have to deposit a collateral on chain. And once this collateral is deposited, the state channel is open, it's active, and then they can trade off chain. And they can trade how much time they want. There is not really any problem of time. They can trade until they want to settle. So let's imagine one user wants to buy Solana for USD, but then there will be a liability from broker A will own from USD to broker B. Broker B will own some Solana to broker A. So basically the liability's value will be balanced until there is a big change in Solana price. And the collateral is there to protect against against the risk of price change. And if at some point the risk becomes too big, but then we can trigger a settlement. And then only have an on-chain transaction where we exchange the different token. And for this, we use a very simple escrow smart contract to exchange the token in a very secure approach. So the traditional finance is composed of very different actors. Each actor have a specific role and responsibility, and especially rules applies to those actors with the regulation. And the cryptocurrency industry is more look like this drawing on the side, where it's really not defined. Some exchanges are doing all the custodian, brokers, they're really mixing responsibilities. And we believe that that's a problem, And for cryptocurrencies industry to grow, it needs to gain in maturity and to implement more regulation. So what are the use cases for this financial layer? So first, OpenWare has a lot of customers who are exchange live in production. So those exchanges are willing to try this new version and to join the network. Then we are developing some tools for fintech entrepreneurs to make very easy for them to deploy exchange at a very low cost, a very low cost of entry, and also a very low cost of operating. And finally, there is crypto enthusiasts who are some geek who can connect to the network, for example, to connect to existing exchange, create some connectors, and so centralized exchange or even decentralized exchange. They can bring their own liquidity and do some market making and push the liquidity on the network. And finally, financial institutions who can connect and offer some services like fiat deposit and withdrawal. So the target is to reach 1,000 nodes deployed on the network for 2025. And for that, we are launching a token. So this is our roadmap. We are here. We are deploying a beta in this quarter on yellow.com. The token sales is supposed to happen this quarter, but I think it's better to wait for a better market conditions. On Q3, we plan to have our public release. Cross-chain settlement and dispute resolution. And finally, Q4, affiliate and reward programs to grow really the community and the platform itself. So what the token will be used for in this system? So first, to enter the network, brokers have to lock some token. So they have to lock 250,000 yellow token to have access to 4 channels on the network, so to be able to peer with 4 different nodes in the network. Then there is the user have the ability to delegate their token to brokers. The liquidity mining will be able to mine liquidity and earn some fees. And finally, they will be able to use token to lower fees on the trading exchange. So that's about the distribution. So we allocated a big portion for stimulating the ecosystem, stimulating a project, for implementing different projects around the network. So we have $15 for the gross hacking, 10% for trading mining, and then 20 for the token sales, and the rest for company treasury, founder, and liquidity provision. Notice that the total supply is 10 billion. So, what is OpenDAX? OpenDAX is the software of OpenWare. It's a turnkey trading appliance, meaning you can, in the latest version we are working on, you can spawn a virtual machine and get in 15 minutes a running exchange. So we are really focused on lowering the capex, so the cost of entry to this technology, and the operating cost to operate the exchange. Because now it's really expensive to operate an exchange. For example, to get a lot of markets, it's really the big problem of exchange to have liquidity on those markets. They have to hire market makers. This service is usually pretty expensive, especially for a startup. So really the point here is to launch the exchange, connect to the network, pull some liquidity, and then you are set up. You have a running exchange with market, with liquidity, and you can build your project. You can focus on what matters to the project, acquiring users, do some partnership, build your community. So still it's secure. So it's natively connected to the Yellow network and it's extremely customizable. So here you have a drawing of the microservice, the internal architecture. What's important to keep in mind is that you have the front end, which is really a specific component that you can customize. And it's fairly easy. And for that, we have a list of partners. So there are software companies that we train with about our technologies so they know how to install, operate, and customize the front end, build some specific integration, KYC provider, fiat integration, or implement a specific feature that an exchange would want to implement. Notice that we have really interesting partnership with ConsenSys and Polygon, Credo, Kobo, Fireblocks as custodian, Aken, Cosio, Zokio security, and for the liquidity, GSR and Acetum. So the customization is made using the OpenDAX SDK. So we published the SDK. So each, it's like a UI toolkit. So you can, like each block on the exchange is actually a specific block. So you can pick up and build your exchange as you want, build your UI, build your experience, really, to make it special, to make it as you want. And it's using React and Next.js technology, so it's really the technologies that are in trend and that are really performing well at the moment. So here is some example of components that you have to build the UI. And a final word about the Yellow ecosystem. So Yellow, it's OpenWare, we talked about it. The Yellow Exchange, yellow.com, which is a showcase of what you can do with the technology and the network. Yellow Incubator and Yellow Capital are services for startups, so financial on one side, incubator program on the other side with a lot of services. You can see a few examples of startups that were incubated. And I would be happy to answer some question if there is any. Don't hesitate to connect. You can find all the links on by scanning this QR code. And join us on Telegram and let's build this this network together. Thank you.